Hello students, this is Amardeep Singh, your computer teacher, and today we are going to continue with the same chapter, Handling Errors and Exceptions. And in this session we'll discuss about handling exceptions and try except blocks. So first we'll discuss about exception handling. As we discussed in previous session that exceptions are abnormal situations, or we can say abnormal conditions available in a program due to which process will terminate before its completion. And the bad impact of exception is that it may cause data loss in a process, because a process, when you will an uncompleted process will terminate, then it will generate some kind of loss, some kind of data loss. For example, if we are talking about a software running on ATM machine, during that transaction, if in between that process will terminate, then there may be some kind of problems, money related or transaction problem will be there. So that's why exceptions are the most dangerous type of errors available in a program. So now we will discuss about exception handling. And one fact is there that we can't remove runtime errors, that means the exception. We can't remove exceptions from a program. As we discussed that we are having three types of error. One is syntax error, logical error, and exception. Syntax error is when a syntax error occur in a program, then you have to make correction on that in that syntax, and by making that kind of correction in the syntax, then you will be able to remove that exception, right? And if we talk about logical errors, so if you will make correction in the logic of the program, then you will get the correct results. So in that way you can remove the logical errors. But the fact is that we can't remove exceptions from a program. We can only handle the exception, we can't remove. So handling exception means to avoid abnormal termination of a program and perform some alternative task. So that means if in normal situation the program will execute successfully and generate correct results, but when the exception occurs, it will terminate the process. So as an exception handler, as a programmer, we have to avoid that termination. And second thing, if the exception occurs, then we have to perform some, we have to run some kind of alternative task, we have to run some alternative statement in response to that exception. So avoiding the abnormal termination and performing some kind of alternative task in response to an exception is known as exception handling. So that one is the fact. Again, I'm going to repeat that we can't remove exceptions, we can't correct exceptions from a program, we can just handle the exceptions. Next we'll discuss how to handle exceptions. As we know that we can't remove exceptions, so that means we are having some kind of mechanism in Python to handle the exception. So we are having try and except blocks to handling exceptions. So first we'll discuss about try block. Try block is basically used to write the statements where exceptions are expected to occur. So that means the main purpose of try block, that we have to write those statements inside the try block where exceptions are expected to occur. And this block will avoid the abnormal termination. If inside the try block, if any exception occur during the execution, then try block will avoid the termination. And second, try block always used with an except block. After the try block, you must define an except block. And the except block is used to perform some that alternative task. It execute only when exception occurred in try block. So that means two blocks we have to use to handle the exception. One is try and second one is except block. Inside try block you have to write those statements where the exceptions are expected to occur, and inside the accept block you have to write those statements that you want to run when exception occur in try block, and the accept block will execute only if the exception occurred in try block. So let's discuss the syntax of try except blocks. So here we are having try block, a try block, then colon, then after that we have to write statement. And here you have to write those statements where exceptions are expected to occur. And after the completion of try block, we have to write except block. And inside except block, you have to write those statements to perform the alternative task in response to an exception. And the except block in with the except block, you can also use object of some exception class. But we'll discuss this portion in next sessions basically. So today we'll use try and except block without any object of exception class with except block. So let's start how to use try except block with an example. So here we are having code that divide two numbers. So in first statement we have get a number from user, then next statement we get a second number from user, and in third statement we are going to divide two numbers, and in last statement we have displayed the result. So just try to run this code. When you will press F5, then there is not any syntax error. Because if the syntax error is there, then the interpreter will not execute the code. So presently we are not having any kind of syntax error. So let's check if we are having any logical error. For example, if I'm giving 10 and second number and 5, then the result must be 2, and the result is also correct. So that means in this code we are not having any kind of logical error also. So in this program, but we are having some exceptions available in this program. So let's try to check the availability of those exceptions. For example, first number I'm going to give 12, and second number I have specified 0. So presently the exception has occurred. So due to exception, the program terminates unexpectedly, and the exception is divide and zero division error. That means we are trying to divide a number by 0. So to check if the process is running successfully, then I'm going to just print the ending and starting message also. This is last statement of program. So this line will indicate that this one is the last statement of program. In the same way, I want to display that this is first statement of a program. So it's just these statements are just to indicate you the indicate about the successful termination of start and termination of a program. Just start the process again, and this one is the start of program. Then next we have to give a value. That means first I'm going to give correct values, then the result is there, and after result that last statement executes. That means program start and end according to the specified statement. And then next, when you will give some wrong input, then the exception will occur, and after this line the program will terminate, and not any statement will be executed after that line, right? But we have to save this, we have to avoid this termination. So if you want to avoid this termination, then you have to write the code inside the try block, and in these statements the exceptions are expected to occur. In first line there is not any situation that the exception will occur, so I will not write this statement inside the try block. So I have to write try, then colon, then indentation block will be there. So you have to indent these statements to write them inside the try block. Then after that, we have to write. We can't use try block without except. If you will try to run this code, then a syntax error will occur. Because by syntax, you have to use except along with the try block. So you have to write except, then colon is there. And inside except block, you have to write that statement that you want to run when exception occur in try block. So I'll write here. I'll just print a message. Exception occurred. So anything you can write inside, but I will not write this statement inside try or exception block, because this statement indicates to the successful end of that process. So after that, just press F5 to run the code. And first of all, I'll give correct values. Then this one is the normal execution of program. The result is correct, and last line also executes. And again, start the program. Then I'll give some wrong input. Now you can check. The program executes successfully without termination. Even the last line is executing here, right? The result of last line is here. So that means the program runs successfully with the error also, with the exception also, but system handled that exception. So that means we have handled the exception. That means the termination has been avoided, and the alternate action, this line executes as alternative action to that exception. So that is all about handling exception. Again, try to run the same. Now I'm going to give input as 12 and second number as a wrong input. I'll give hello. Then now even system handles that error. So this one is known as the exception handling. So by using try and except block, you will be able to avoid the termination of program, and with the except block, you will be able to define some statement that will execute when exception occur inside the try block. So that is all about the try and except blocks. If you people are having any kind of doubt related to exception handling and the use of try and except block,